The father of a teenager who allegedly stabbed a bishop inside a church in Sydney's West reportedly had no idea his son may have been radicalised. After the attack, the father fled to his mosque, too scared to go home, fearing he may be set upon by rioters who'd already turned on police.
At the church where their colleagues became targets, police were back today looking for the rioters responsible for Monday's mayhem. It broke out after a Syrian Christian bishop, Marmari Emmanuel, was stabbed mid-sermon. The attack, live-streamed to thousands, lit a match in Western Sydney. But before police could even get the alleged teenage terrorist out of the church, the 16-year-old's identity was being shared on chat groups.
This kid has been poisoned. His name is... These kids have been poisoned by a monster that has the radical Daesh mentality.
Today, his parents didn't respond to that claim as they packed up and left their home.
Is there anything you want to say about your son's actions? Do you think he was radicalised by someone at all?
His family seeking guidance from local Muslim leaders.
You would never have seen a more humble, simple father than the boy's father. He was distraught. He would not go home. He was scared to go home because he thought he was going to get arrested. Did he see the signs? He said no. All he saw was a troublesome teenager who wasn't listening to his father.
Detectives are now investigating whether the teen was influenced by anyone else and if he was a known threat.
Where did he come from? Who's behind it? Is there any other imminent threats? And did the government know about it?
It's not the first attack like this in Sydney.
We have seen it before. Unfortunately, there are parallels with the tragic death of Curtis Chang in 2015.
So too the 2016 arrest of teens outside a Bankstown prayer hall plotting an attack with hunting knives.
I think it's a reminder that terrorism hasn't gone away. You know, it takes different forms, it evolves, and we see different types of terrorism.
Violent extremism has no place in this country. Violence has no place in this country.
We have a problem, and we're not denying that we have a problem. We've been begging government for a youth centre.
53-year-old Marmari Emmanuel's condition is now stable. Other churchgoers injured, all now released.
While the bishop remains here in hospital, his teenage attacker is also still being treated for his injuries and undergoing a mental health assessment. Detectives say charges against him aren't likely for a few days.
Officers bolstered by rarely used counter-terrorism powers.
We are seeing a trend where it is harder for us to discern when a terrorist attack like this may occur, but I would say that police and our law enforcement officials are very good at this, and I'm confident in their abilities.